everyone, welcome back to my channel. Before I say anything, don't mind the hair and the shirt, you know, with, you know, baby spit up stains. Today has been a hectic day with the kids and this is the only minute I had to film this video. Therefore, the hair and the shirt are gonna suffer. Okay, I get so many people asking me, and I had these exact same questions when I was starting out into my health and fitness journey. I get tons of people asking, where do I start? There is so much information out there. There are so many supplements, there are so many diets, workouts, literally everything. And when you kind of start researching and start looking into being healthier and just making small changes to be healthy, you are overwhelmed, at least I was, with the amount of, you know, supplements you should be taking and the amount of things you should be doing. And you're like, where do I start? What is the most important to get me on the right track? So I decided that I would start a series on this channel, something called something to do with like baby steps to health or something, where basically every week I would share anywhere between 1 to 3 small little baby changes you can make to be a healthier you. So little small steps. So basically it'll be helping you, you know, where you should be starting. I will either be sharing supplements or you know, anything like that that you should be taking or things you should be doing to help you start off your health and fitness journey. Just little small changes you have to make, they're nothing huge. And then hopefully every week, you know, you, as you do these every single day, they will become a part of your routine and you can start adding things in slowly, you know, more supplements and things like that. And it won't be overwhelming because you'll be doing it very slowly. So if you like this idea, then give this video a thumbs up or comment down below and let me know, just so I know that it's something that you guys actually want to see. But today I will be sharing the 3 small, tiny little baby steps that you can take to just be a healthier you. Just tiny little small changes you can make to your lifestyle already. So number one is drink water. I know a ton of people love sodas and juice. I personally don't like soft drinks. I only drink water and teas. But that has just been me my whole life. I rather consume my calories than drink them. If I'm gonna have sugar, I'd rather have a chocolate bar. That's just kind of how I've been. Can you stay outside there for now, honey? So personally, that's just me. But my small change for you is if you wanna drink your soft drinks, for now, continue. In the future, when I post more videos, it'll be one of those things I'll be having you change. But for now, just drink water. You want your pop, drink it, but on top of that, drink water. Try and go for at least 8 cups a day. I know it is very hard to get water into your day if you're not used to drinking it. So either infuse it, drink it as an herbal tea. Coconut water helps too, but there is sugar in it, so try and just stick to regular water. But just do it. Just every day, fill up as much, you know, 8 cups, so that's 2 liters. Fill up a 2-liter bottle or jug or cups. Have them ready, and every hour, have a timer on your watch or your phone or something, and just drink one. Just do it. Eventually, it will become really easy to get it down, and you won't really, you know, feel like it's a chore anymore. There goes a kid. Okay, you be good. Be very quiet, your sister's sleeping. You won't feel like it's a chore and you'll actually be thirsty and you'll be wanting to drink. So this is gonna help you flush things out of your body. Water helps you lose weight. Your entire body is like something like 70% water or something like that. You need water for every cell, every system in your brain to function. So drink water, 100%. Tip number 2 is switch up your oils. Basically, if you're using canola oil, vegetable oil, even sunflower oil, get rid of them. This is a very small change you can do, but oils have a huge impact with your health. Not only are canola oils and vegetables and all that, and soybean oils very, very highly refined and processed, they're also not organic usually, and they basically make you fat. They make you gain weight. They are so unhealthy for you. They are not healthy fats whatsoever. So get rid of those oils and just switch to these oils, which I will be showing you right now. They are a little bit more expensive, but so worth it in the long run. And to me, they taste way better. My very first all-time favorite oil for cooking, for baking, for skin, hair, everything. You guys probably know it is coconut oil. This is from Costco. It is huge, yes, because we go through it like crazy around here. But you want to make sure it's organic and virgin. Virgin coconut oil, 100%. It's so good in baking. I use this for everything though. The next thing, next oil you could use, which is my second favorite, is avocado oil. This is 100% pure avocado oil. What I love about this and the coconut is that it has a very high smoke point. So you can cook it at very high temperatures without, you know, burning oil and creating carcinogens and, you know, unhealthy things. So avocado oil, this would be a good substitute for like grape seed oil or something because it doesn't really have any flavor. So good for baking, good for cooking if you don't want, you know, any flavor. My third and final oil I will be sharing with you that you could switch with is olive oil, extra virgin organic olive oil. Again, these are all from Costco. Sorry, the kids are all loud. These are all from Costco, but you can really get them from anywhere. Just make sure they're organic and a good quality. I'm sorry. Organic and a good quality, and you will notice a huge difference, not only in your weight, but in your hair and skin. And oh my gosh, look at them back there. Your hair and your skin and all that, because they are healthy fats. These are all healthy fats and ones you need in your body. One more thing I want to quickly add about the coconut oil is that coconut oil are medium chain fat. There's medium chain fatty acids in coconut oil, which basically means your body doesn't have to go through much work. It's readily available to use as energy. So therefore, when you're eating coconut oil, it doesn't get stored as fat like other oils would. It actually is used for energy because it's so easy to break down for your body. So good tip just there if you want to, you know, if you're looking for a better oil in terms of weight loss, I would really recommend coconut oil. It's my 100% my favorite oil. I use it for everything. My third and final tip is getting a little bit of movement in your week. So what I mean by movement, I don't mean getting a gym membership, lifting weights. I don't mean anything like that. Maybe just 3 days a week. Try and go for a 20 to 30 minute fast-paced walk. Get your heart rate up, maybe get a little bit out of breath, a little bit of a sweat. 30 minutes, 45 to an hour is better, but if that is too much for you, or you know, too daunting and you're like, oh, I don't like working out, I don't want like exercising, just start with 3 days a week, 20 to 30 minutes, fast-paced walk. If you don't wanna go outside to walk, if it's too hot or too cold or too rainy, get a treadmill. There are some cheap ones that you can get. They don't have to be anything fancy, but just enough to get your heart rate going. Get a stationary bike in your house. If that's not an option, then literally walk around your living room as long as it takes for 20 minutes, okay? Go up and down your stairs as long as it takes for 20 minutes. As many times as it takes, sorry, for 20 minutes. Just do something but move for 20 minutes. If 20 minutes is too long and you want something even less than that, do a 4 to 10 minute HIIT workout. It's better than doing nothing. It gets your heart rate up. You'll be burning calories long after you are done working out. They say up to 10 hours if you do a HIIT workout. They're short, they're fast, but they are intense. They will get your heart rate up. They will get you to sweat, which is what you want. You want to sweat to get toxins out of the body. So just get moving. Like I said, 3 days a week. Doesn't have to be every day. Doesn't have to be anything crazy. Just something that can get your heart rate up and make you sweat. I don't recommend running, and I'll probably make a video on running later on. But I love walking, and biking is a great option as well. So you maybe purchase a bike and go biking around your neighborhood. So these are my top three tips and the biggest things I think that could really transform your health. If you've already done these steps, then great, look out for my next videos, which will be even more tips. But if you haven't and you don't know where to start with that. Water, switch up your oils. Don't use the bad, unhealthy oils. Use high quality, good, healthy fats. And just get moving. These three tips, you will notice a huge difference, not only in weight loss, but also in the way you feel, your mood, mental, physically, your skin, everything. You will notice a huge difference. So let me know if you like this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up down below. Subscribe to my channel, and I will see you in my next one. Bye, guys.